name is Garett Gilcrease with Syngenta Crop Protection. I come to you from this Fiesta vineyard here in Central California, where we have a trial going on that's looking at the efficacy of different products against powdery mildew. Powdery mildew is of great concern to the grape grower right now. This weather, the time of year, and the growth stage of the crop really promote its incidence, and Fiesta is extremely susceptible to this pathogen. Our product we're looking at today is Miravis Prime fungicide. We're also looking at that in comparison to other competitive products that are currently on the market. Our goal for this is to demonstrate the efficacy of Miravis Prime as well as its crop safety and overall fit into an IPM program. Come with me while I show you the different treatments and what we're seeing out there right now. Okay, so what you can see here is a Miravis Prime plot as I'm walking across it. What I want you guys to look at is the not only the crop safety, but also just the viability and everything of these plots here. You can see that the leaves are nice and green. We have even this nice succulent leaf tissue, some of these here. We got excellent control. You can see no powdery mildew on these. The incidence is very, very low. The crop has really responded to this Miravis Prime treatment. You can see that overall crop safety and performance as of now is very, very good. As we move over here to a competitive plot, you can see right there, we just moved over to this competitive plot. Things do start to change rapidly. Here's the very edge of it. We can see little bits of phyto here and there, but as we get further into this plot, we can see more and more things like this. This was leaf tissue present at time of application. You could think if you use this product for one of your growers, that you would definitely be getting a call about, hey, what happened with this fungicide? This fungicide here is Luna Sensation fungicide. It was applied just like the Miravis Prime with Dinuba. And you can see that we have just a little bit of issues here and there in terms of phytotoxicity, maybe not quite the best powdery mildew control, but this is something that in this day and age where the crop is not bringing the return on investment that we'd like, we need to have the best quality control and the best return on investment of our product, and this is not performing with that at the current moment. This is the untreated control. You can see there's lots and lots of mildew in here. I'll zoom in real quick, see all the mildew on the stem, the berries. This cluster may not even make it to harvest with any kind of marketable berries. Going over here, these right here, this is the pristine at 12.5 fluid ounces treatment. You can see we still have some mildew throughout there, not nearly as bad as the untreated control. So it's giving us something. It's just not what would be called acceptable during this time. But you can see it's giving us better than the untreated check. Now we go over to the Luna Sensation treatment here. This cluster right here, you can see we got a little bit of mildew on the front of it, but within the cluster it is slightly cleaner, but we do have some discoloration on the stem as well. That's gonna be a source of inoculum as this cluster gets tighter and tighter and sprays are harder to penetrate. The last one here, the last clusters I have are from the Miravis Prime treatment at 13.4 fluid ounces. You can see that stem is very clean. The berries are very clean. We're going into this here. Now I will say that nothing is 100% clean. You can see a little bit of mildew on a berry there. You can see a little bit of mildew throughout in periods of this cluster. But what I will say is that it is markedly cleaner than a lot of the other products out here. But again, these are Fiesta grapes here. These are probably the worst of the worst. This is the toughest pressure that you're going to see, and so these products are under a lot of stress, as you can see by this untreated control.